with a legacy that spans over 40 years and one of the most important names in hard rock and metal guitars. Jackson are no doubt no strangers to anyone who likes their riffs hard and their shapes outrageous. But with quite a few different guitars and series to choose from, which one is right for you? I'm going to go through all the different series and models of Jackson guitars today, starting with the bass level all the way up to their brand new American range. Explain what makes them different and of course, play some riffs. Now, like most of our videos, we've split this up into chapters, so if there's a particular series or kind of style of guitar you want to see, just check them below because we might cover that in this video. But let's start off right at the beginning with the JS series. GS series is Jackson's entry point to their line, with all their models represented and a plethora of colours to choose from. It's the absolute perfect diving in point for anybody who just wants to check out the Jackson brand as a beginner or maybe just even wants to save some money. The GS series begins with the GS11 and the GS12. The main difference between those two being that the 11 has 22 frets and the 12 has got 24 frets, like this one I've got in my lap right now. Both of them are these sort of style of super strat with a bolt-on neck. They've got poplar bodies, non-locking trims, and high output Jackson pickups. Now, as I mentioned, this being the bolt-on model, which basically just means that the neck is bolted onto the body just right here. This is known as the Dinky, and I'm going to go over the names of all the models in just a minute as they carry over to all the other lines, and it's just easier to get that out of the way quite early. The GS line also includes a few other models as well, which are the GS22, the 24, and the 32. As you step up to the 22 range, the configurations such as the pickups or the trims are pretty much the same across the board, the only main difference being that the 22 has an arch top to it. Now, what this means is the top of the guitar isn't flat, it's actually got an arch to it. Now, this isn't really going to change playability, but for some people they just kind of like that slightly more 3D look to it, and it's, you know, it's not this complete flat top that we've got on this guitar. The GS24 is exclusive to the Dinky bolt-on model also. It's ever so slightly upgraded to this one here, featuring a mahogany body instead of the poplar, and it actually has a roasted maple neck too. These also mark the first models that include those iconic shark fin inlays, which you'll see on several of the guitars. Much like the next one we're going to talk about, the GS32 Warrior, which has those shark fins there. The 32 series is where things start to get a little bit more fun, and we start to see the inclusion of some of these iconic crazy body shapes, as well as the inclusion of a Floyd Rose locking trim. When we jump onto the next range, I'll explain kind of what a Floyd Rose is as well and how it can be a little bit more tricky for a beginner. But when we're moving up to the 32, as I mentioned, the aesthetics start to change a little bit. Some of the woods are a little bit different. You start to get the shark fin inlays there, as well as binding on the neck. Before we move on from the JS range too as well, it is worth shouting out the Minion series. These are basically a couple of models that are smaller versions of the Jackson guitars that you would expect to see, which are absolutely perfect for those little riffers in your life who want to get a bit of a head start on their guitar journey. So I'm going to quickly explain the different Jackson body shapes just now. This just will save me a little bit of time in the kind of later portions of this video, as we'll get all the shapes out of the way just now so you know what they are, and it just lets me focus on the important changes and kind of more of the important stuff. So we have already seen the Dinky, and the main kind of difference with that to some of the other guitars is that it's the super strat shape with a bolt on neck. A lot of players will actually say that the bolt-on neck there will give you a slightly different tone, and of course there will be a slightly different feel, especially if you're kind of down the dusty end of the neck there. You're going to kind of feel that little join there just in the back of your hand. Not anything uncomfortable, but definitely something to bear in mind. Similar to the Dinky, there is actually another super strat in the Jackson line as well, and that is known as the Soloist, which this is a model we're going to touch on just a little bit later too. The easiest way for anybody to tell the difference between a Dinky and a Soloist, of course, is how the neck joins there. So with the Soloist, it is actually a neck through construction, which means that the neck is actually physically glued into the body here, and it's made to sort of replicate just one solid bit of wood here. This is really a preference thing, as with the neck through, you can kind of get a bit closer to those higher frets without that sort of bump coming out the back here, and it will provide a slightly different tone as well and a little bit extra sustain. But what I'd suggest is getting both in your lap, seeing which one you prefer. As I said, there's no right or wrong answer with that. The next guitar is the Monarch, and this is the single cut design in Jackson's catalogue, maybe one of the slightly more understated models you're going to see. The main draw of this being it still has that sort of Jackson DNA in it, so it can handle the hard rock or metal. This is maybe for somebody who kind of prefers those slightly more old school sort of designs, or again, just something not particularly pointy. Now let's move into some more spiky territory, starting with the Randy Rhodes or the RR, the Warrior and the Kelly, the King V. Multiple versions of these iconic shapes show up through the entire Jackson line, and they will all have varying different specs. The main thing to really focus on first though is of course which you find the coolest, so obviously choose which kind of line you're going to go into, and then within there you're going to be able to find the perfect guitar for you. Much like other guitar brands, Jackson of course have got a few signature models to select from. These are designed hand in hand with the artist, so of course they're going to have their own specific specs and colours and shape and all that sort of stuff. Players include Misha Mansour of Periphery, Phil Collins from Def Leppard, and Marty Friedman, who actually plays the Monarch shape. So moving onwards and upwards, we are going to be looking at the X series next. Now, the most notable changes are really going to be, of course, with spec, but of course, aesthetics are going to start to shift up a little bit with this range as well. Most notably, we have an upgraded locking trim on the X series, which has moved up from a Jackson branded one to an actual Floyd Rose branded one on this guitar. As I mentioned previously when we were talking about the GS range, some of those guitars actually do come with a Floyd Rose, and I'll just kind of touch on that very quickly for anyone who isn't quite sure. To put it in its simplest terms, a Floyd Rose or locking trim system is essentially a locking mechanism that locks your strings at the bridge and up at the nut here as well. What that essentially allows you to do is kind of go crazy on your tremolo arm there to make some kind of crazy noises and sort of wild changes to your pitch there without your guitar going out of tune due to it being locked obviously at two positions. Now, by no means is this an advanced sort of system, but it can certainly be quite intimidating for a beginner just due to the restring process, and even things like tuning aren't as simple as just, you know, turning the machine heads on the headstock there. You either need to unlock that or use your micro tuners at the bridge here. Now, if you are interested in a Floyd Rose and you want to get a bit more explanation on how to change the strings, we did a restringing video that you can click above my head and down in the description there. That can kind of give you a bit of a taste of what to expect if you were to get one of these guitars. Circling back to what I said about the hardware being upgraded in the X series, what you'll notice with an upgraded Floyd Rose, especially if you are using it quite a lot as well, is it's just going to feel a lot smoother. You're going to have a bit of an easier time, you know, with the traction of it, and it'll actually just, you know, keep your strings a little bit more in tune and just kind of hold those locks a little bit better than, say, a slightly cheaper one that would be included in the GS range. Along with those upgrades, the X series does mark the first use of active pickups in the Jackson range. Now, active pickups essentially are just pickups that run off a 9-volt battery, and they're used across all of hard rock and metal, though they have a very distinctive tone to them, and again, they're not necessary for that sort of genre. They can provide you with quite a unique tone and they sound great. Double check when you are looking at any of the guitars in the X series, if they have a 9-volt battery compartment on the back, they're going to be active. And for those who want to know as well, non-active pickups are called passive pickups. Looking into our next line, we are looking at the Pro Series, and much like the X Series to the GS range, we're going to notice an upgrade in hardware, aesthetics, and just general build quality across the board. For example, this Pro Series Dinky here is quite a bit different from the GS Dinky that we looked at the start of the video. Obviously, not only looks wise, but as I mentioned, hardware wise and what goes into this guitar, there is quite a bit different. The most notable difference with this particular Pro Series Dinky is actually the inclusion of Fishman Fluence pickups in here, which are a huge name in the modern metal scene at the moment. But across the board with the Pro Series, you will notice a lot of different pickups in them, including Seymour Duncan and EMG, who are two huge names in the pickup scene. Of course, the wood that's used in the Pro Series guitar is a little bit different from the previous guitars that we looked at here, as this one is actually a baked ash wood that is used on here, and it's got this really cool sandblasted finish to it as well, which I don't know if you can notice it on the main camera there, but that's got quite a sort of 3D finish to it, and it feels really, really cool. This compared to the slightly cheaper poplar that was used on the previous guitars, you're just getting a little bit more bang for your buck with this, and it's going to provide a slightly different tone. Baked ash isn't the only thing that they use with the Pro Series as well, as you can get yourself a mahogany body, which is going to, again, give you a slightly different tone and just gives you quite a few different choices to find the absolute perfect guitar. Sticking with wood, it's worth mentioning that the fingerboards on these have all been upgraded as well with ebony, which is actually quite a premium option that you don't see a lot of on guitars, but it is this really nice kind of dark wood, which is really smooth and again very suited to kind of hard rock and metal playing. You'll see that on a lot of guitars. Any of the models in the Pro Series that also have a Floyd Rose tremolo on them have all been upgraded as well, from just a Floyd Rose Special to a Floyd Rose 1000. So again, just incremental kind of stepping up in quality, and you're just going to notice that it's going to be a better guitar. Finally as well, they all come loaded with locking tuners as well, which again, another great premium option. It is also worth mentioning a relatively new line in the Jackson Pro series, which is the Pro Plus range. Now, this series only includes a couple of shapes in it, and essentially what they are doing is completely supercharging what you're getting with a Pro Series guitar. In this range, we have two models of Dinky, which is the DKA and the MDK, and we also have a soloist, which I've got in my lap just now, which goes under an SLA name. The biggest changes and additions is the use of an Akomi body. We have this multiple wood neck. We have luminly side dots, which means you can see your fret markers in the dark. The superb finishes can't be overlooked as well, and with the MDK model, they come loaded with an Evertune bridge. Pro Plus range are perfect for any modern guitarist who are looking to sort of push the boundaries on what's technically possible on a Jackson. The next range we're going to look at, and which kind of shares some of the DNA with the Pro Plus range, is the Concept series. Now, unfortunately, we don't have one of them in the studio today because they're super popular, but essentially they are the smallest Jackson line, and some of the stuff that goes into them is quite unique and quite cool. There are four models available, and like I said, they kind of share some of the same ethos as the Pro Plus here. What Jackson says is these are some concepts and some guitars that were really born out of kind of a custom shop mentality. So you're going to see like a Randy Rhoads guitar with a humbucker and a single coil, and it's going to, you know, it's have a quite unique finish on it. There's also a couple of models as well that are extended range with just crazy finishes too. Definitely check those out. We are almost at the end of the journey, so thanks for sticking with me for this, but I'm sure you'll come away with knowing what the entire Jackson line is looking like after this video. Our next step is moving away from the Indonesian and Chinese made guitars, as Jackson have actually got their own made in Japan range also, which comes in the form of this Randy Rhoads model in my hands right now. The ethos of the MJ line kind of calls back to the 90s when all of Jackson's import guitars were coming from Japan and they had this absolutely superb quality to them. It's no secret that Japanese made guitars have been great for years and this line is absolutely no different. Now, I might sound a bit like a broken record at this point, but as we step up through to the MJ series, you're going to notice obviously certain parts are going to be upgraded from what we were just looking at previously. I guess the biggest thing to really explain when we start moving up to these sort of guitars is actually more feel than anything. As some of the specs are shared with the Pro and the Pro Plus range, I can really feel the attention to detail that has went into this guitar. And again, it's hard to explain, but it just feels a lot better and a lot kind of more focused as an instrument, and that will just really help you kind of, you know, get to your maximum potential. At the moment, the MJ series consists of a Dinky, a Soloist, and the RR, but it is worth checking out the signature model of the Periphery riffer Misha Mansour, as he has a really cool SoCal model, which is kind of harkening back to an old 80s sort of super strat, but it looks super cool as well. Last but by no means least, we have the American range in the Jackson catalog. Now, Jackson do make a lot of custom shop guitars from America. One of the most important things with this range is it marks the first guitars that they are making in Corona, California. Now, we already have quite a detailed video that we shot last year when the Soloist model came out, if you do want to check that out, again above my head in the description there. I want to touch on the Virtuoso model that only came out very recently. Like its predecessor, the Virtuoso is made in Corona, California, which is actually where all of the American Fender guitars are made as well. So if that's not a seal of approval for the quality that goes into this, then I don't know what is. With a ton of superb features in this guitar, including the 5-piece caramelized maple neck and the Seymour Duncan humbuckers here, which actually have a 5-way selector, you can get quite a lot of sounds out of this guitar that aren't just suited to metal. So this can actually be your sort of all-over guitar that can handle nearly anything you throw at it. Certainly, if this is a sign of things to come from Jackson, then I can certainly say I'm very excited to see what comes down the line. Certainly, I think we'll be seeing this name on a headstock for another 40 years to come and then some. So that was our quick fire tour through all of the Jackson range there. Hopefully this has cleared some stuff up for you and again helps you find the perfect model for you. But what do you think? Let us know down in the comments if you're a Jackson player and there's a particular model that you gravitate towards. Give us a like and a subscribe while you're down there as well. That really helps the channel. But until next time, I've been Keiran and this has been the entire Jackson range. Have a great day. We'll be right back.
We'll be right back.